welcome to part 3 of this Making a Game in HypeHype tutorial series. This time, we're going to be taking a look at premades and add-ons. So let's open our draft from the last video. This time, we're going to start taking a look at the game logic, so make sure that you are in Game Editor. So we're going to open up the asset library and tap on premades. Now, premades are objects that come with some of the game logic already applied. There's a lot of different premades that can do different things, and they're all designed to work together. So for example, a premade enemy will be able to damage a premade player without you having to touch any logic nodes. Now in the first video, we already added a premade character. The doll here is in the way and we don't need them anymore, so we're just going to remove that from the scene. Alright, so if you haven't added a playable character yet, now is the time to add one to your scene. So here, I've used the runner player Nova premade. We can playtest this right away, and you can see that we now have a character that can run around, that can jump. We can rotate the camera by swiping, and there is a health system. Let's check out the details panel. First thing to note is that we don't need to keep the character model. We can change this if we want to by tapping on the model on the top right. Here, we can replace it with any other character that we may want to use. When replacing character models, just keep in mind that you're going to want to keep the same type of model. So for example, if you replace a humanoid model with an animal model, for example, this quirky dog right here, the animations are going to become nightmare fuel. I'll show you right here. This doesn't really work. So we're going to undo that. And it's also a good idea to select a model of a similar size. Some of the logic might be based on the size of the character or the height of the character, so changing these too much means that something in the game may break. So for example, if we scale this character up to be way too big, it'll no longer be able to detect when it's touching the ground, and it's just going to be in a permanent jump animation. Okay, so let's undo that and select a new model for our character. I really like Mr. Mustache, so we're going to go with him for this one. We can also customize this player further by gluing some objects to it. So just open the asset library, look for whatever you want to glue to them. We're going to search for hat. We'll select whichever one you want. Let's add a wizard hat for him. Then we're going to want to rotate it and place it onto him like so. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. We can now glue the hat by dragging from the glue icon to the player. When gluing objects to a player, it's important to choose the correct body part that you're gluing it onto. For example, if we glue this hat to the arm instead of the head, it's gonna move really weirdly when we run around. Like this. Yeah, so it follows the trajectory of the arm instead of the head. So let's go back and glue it to the correct part of his body, which would be the head. Now it's gonna bob along nicely as we run. You can add as many objects as you want to a player. But one thing to keep in mind as you're gluing objects to a character is to keep them visual only, unless it's absolutely necessary. Gluing objects with physics properties to your character will affect the overall physics of the player model, and that's going to change how it feels to play. Now, we can customize with more than just visuals and premades. Let's turn our attention back to the basic details panel. Okay, so at the bottom, we have listed all of the add-ons that are used on this premade. And most add-ons have some editable parameters. So, for example, we can tap on player controls to expand this tab. And for example here, you can see that speed, jump power, and jumps allowed can be edited. If you want to customize the logic beyond these parameters, you can do that as well. Just deselect the player and take a look at the builder panel in the top right. And you can tap on the puzzle icon to view the add-ons. So from here, you can select an add-on, for example, turn camera, and press the edit button. This is going to open up a container that holds all of the logic for that add-on. In the next video, we're going to start taking a look at working with logic nodes. And later in this series, we're going to take a more in-depth look at editing premades and add-ons or reusables. For now, let's just hide this container by tapping on the eye icon. Okay, now let's take another look at the game camera. Some premades have the ability to take over the controls of the game camera, like the player that we have added right here. In these cases, the game camera will move to the correct position to see the player, but it's still based on the position of the starting game camera. Our default camera here was really close, so let's move a little further away, and on the left panel, click on Set Camera. Now when we playtest, the camera is going to be a little further away than before. Keep in mind that the camera is going to be moved by the premade that we've selected, so the view that you get during the gameplay might be a little bit different than from the view that you get in the editor. So for example, if we set the camera to look at the player from a little bit of an odd angle, the premade will rotate the camera so that it is directly behind the player instead. So now that we've got a playable character and a camera angle we like, let's save our project. In the next video, we're going to delve into the wonderful world of logic by creating a finish line with some endgame logic. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm going to see you next time. Welcome to part 3 of this making a tutorial series in HypeHype. I feel you staring at me.
I'm looking at this
You can tap on player controls to expand. These sentences are so long.